So I am delving more into this. I'm looking at Polypath. I downloaded a PDF that was available there. Look at here a bank, a home loan bank. And what are they saying? We switched to Polypath based on this round to watch market values, produce reliable risk model. We looked at the system, we identified we could produce valuation risk measure for a complex set of financial instrument, coverage, fidelity to capital market, accurate experience on the street price database, and so on. So the most of these asset liability management is plain fixed income, and we are looking at a wide variety of fixed income instruments like mortgages and structured product. Ultimately, these structured product, again, they are built up from the mortgages and the other loans that bank give. If I zoom more into this, you have a CMO, you have pool, you have hedge, and everything is being played down here. Let me zoom out a little bit. So here is the asset liability management system that we wanted to look at. So you have simulation setup, tree definition, balance sheet upload, new product, strategy growth, and a report. There was some other PDF that I am downloading here. You have a desktop trader, distributed system, enterprise, and CAL server. So of course this means that your calculations are done at a different grid, enterprise level, and everything is stored into something like an SQL from where you can pull. If you look here, you can understand, and this is for trading and risk management. And this is again the same price for trading and risk management. Another file here, I think this is the same. So this is what I downloaded. You can check out some of these documents as well to get more idea about what they are doing. So eager calculation, I'm not sure what this is about, but probably this is some architecture to compute the values. However, this is not much of what we want to look at. We would rather look at those basic models that they would build up. A similar kind of a thing you can search for the QRM asset liability. So, an asset degree of interest rate, liquidity management style, institutional financial decision style, ALM, and so on. So this seems a good link for that. So I would save this link. This could be used in some of the other things or the explanation that I make. So benchmark study. Now in this part, I'm going to look at some of the software used for asset liability management. We are looking at two softwares here. The first is Polypath, and we are looking more towards asset liability management. Just look at the words here. Polypath asset liability integrates accounting and income simulation with market value, economic, and risk. So your accounting information and your income on how the market value would move. So you are integrating the movement of market, the economics of market on your income, on your accounting statement. So that's a kind of an asset liability model that you can think of. Now it has got some accounting framework as well as which you can call also like a reporting framework, as well as it has got the models of all the financial instruments that we might look at. So for example, We have comprehensive instrument coverage. We have risk and return analysis, the trading and hedging kind of a thing. We have these kind of things run on a grid of computer system, like a grid of four or five system. So a high computation power is required for this one. You can also probably get the brochures. I'm not sure about that. But let's move to the other software, that's QRM, again the asset liability management. If you look at what it is telling, it says that our asset ma liability management and market risk engagement enable clients to most model the most complex asset liabilities and optional instruments. QRM consultant to remove out the complexity. So if you are a bank that has some mortgages, you would probably find out how markets would go and how that would affect pricing of different instruments that you can have. So as a bank, you might have an exposure to a lot of these instruments. If you are focusing on a bank that is mostly dealing with mortgages, then it might have a lot of exposure to them. Now the other part is looking at your balance sheet and find out how your balance sheet would move at different economic scenario. That's also called stress testing, and what are the effective hedges that you can take on that. So there are two ways in which you can look here. Either you can look at the software, or again we are going to look at some of the academic stuff here, like the CFA level 2 stuff.